Hi everyone, welcome to the RP Presents Chemistry. Now let us continue our lectures on GOC series, GOC chemistry series. This is the lecture number 4. So today we are going to discuss about attacking reagents. Okay, now the types of attacking reagents, how many types of attacking reagents are available? Okay, so what are those types of different attacking reagents? Okay, now before going to the attacking reagents, let's discuss the some of the basic part of organic reactions. Okay, now here it is the simply it is a substrate molecule. Substrate can convert into a new material that is nothing but product. Okay, substrate can convert into product. So substrate directly cannot convert into product, but with the help of some other species, those species are called reagent. Okay, those species are called reagents. So substrate which is attacked by the reagents and it can convert into product. Okay, so the reagent, the species which can changes the substrate to product, which is nothing but reagent. Okay, so this is the reagent. Which plays the role which can convert the substrate to product. So this is called reagent. So here the reagent type of, this is simply it is nothing but attacking reagents. Now here two types of attacking reagents are there. So one is the electrophilic attacking reagents. Electrophilic attacking reagent. Another one is nucleophilic attacking reagents. So these are the two types of electrophilic and nucleophilic attacking reagents. Okay, now here electrophilic is nothing but electro means electron. Okay, now here philic means it is nothing but loving or attracting species. Okay, simply now here also nucleo means nucleus. Here philic means loving or attracting power. Simply it is nothing but attracting power. Okay, so now here according to the their definition, so electrophilic is nothing but electron philic reagents. Philic is nothing but love, so electron loving species. Simply it is called as electrophile. Okay, now here according to their definition of their name is nothing but a nucleus loving species or nucleus attracting species. Simply it is nothing but a nucleus loving species are called as nucleophiles. Okay, now let us discuss these electrophilic attacking reagents and nucleophilic attacking reagents very clearly. Okay, so now 7 to 8 types of electrophiles are there. Electrophiles, different types of electrophiles are available. Here also almost all same type of nucleophiles are also there. Okay, now let's go through the one by one very clearly. Okay, now let's move on to the first of all, electrophilic attacking reagents. Simply it is called as electrophiles. So how many electrophiles are there? Simply, so according to their definition, electrophilic reagents is nothing but electron loving species or electron attracting species. So what is the sign of electron? Electron is nothing but a negatively charged species. So negative charged attracting reagents, simply it is called negatively charged species loving species. Okay, negatively charged loving species is nothing but electrophiles. So which type of species which loves the negatively charged species? If it is positive, then only it loves the negative species. Okay, otherwise it cannot loves the negative species. Okay, negative cannot loves, that means cannot attract to each other. But a negative can attract the positively charged species. Okay, now here, so our reagent, if it is positively charged species, then only it loves the or it attracts the negatively charged species like an electron. Okay, now here, simply according to our definition, positively charged species simply is called as electrophiles. Okay, now the positively charged species is nothing but H+, simply halogen plus, Br+, Cl+, iodine plus, these type of halogens are also available. Now again, like a RCO plus, this is acyl carbocation, acyl ion or is simply acyl carbocation. Okay, those type of acyl cations. Now again, something NO plus, HSO3 plus. Okay, these type of positively charged species are called as electrophiles. Okay, now here the first point is positively charged species are called as electrophiles. Now here something like lithium plus, potassium plus, sodium plus, magnesium plus 2, like a calcium plus 2. These are also positively charged species. Here it is nothing but alkali metals and alkali earth metal cations. So these are also electrophiles, but these are very like weak electrophiles. Why? Because very worst, that means a worst electrophile. Simply it is a weak electrophile. Why? Because it is a weak electrophile. Here in like a sodium, let us take the sodium. Sodium is the atomic number 11. So sodium can convert into like a sodium plus, that means it atomic number can convert into 10. Okay, so 10 is the nothing but a noble gas configuration, neon noble gas electronic configuration. It is equal to the neonic configuration. Okay, now the losing of electron, it gains the like a stability, octet stability. So that's why here it cannot need to lose their electrons, or it cannot lead to attract the negatively charged species. That's why it is the stable species. Okay, so the stable cationic species are weak electrophiles. The stable cationic species are weak electrophiles. That's why, note the point. Now, alkali and alkali earth metals are weak electrophiles. Now, again, another drawback is there. That is another drawback of our positively charged species statement. Okay. Now, here, NH4 plus is there. Here it is the cation. Here it is the cation. So all the cations, simply positively charged species, all the positively charged species are electrophiles, whether it is correct or wrong. Okay, all the positively charged species are electrophiles, whether it is correct or wrong. So it's absolutely wrong. Okay, all the positively charged species cannot electrophile. So some of the exceptions are there. So now here it is the ammonium cation. Okay, now here ammonium cation means here it is the nitrogen. Here it having the lone pairs, that is the ammonia. So those lone pairs which abstract the H plus electrophile, then it appears as a NH4 plus. Now let us take the orbital diagram. So now nitrogen is a 2s2 2p3, its valence electronic configuration. Now here 2s2 2p3, three electrons. So these three electrons can shared by the hydrogen, three hydrogens, a single electrons. And now here it forms the three bonds. So those are the NH3 bond. Okay. Now here these lone pair electrons can shared the pair of electrons to the protons. Shared the pair of electrons to the towards the H plus. That is nothing but a proton. Okay. Now all the orbitals are involved in the bond formation. Then only it is possible for the NH4 plus. So if cation, let us assume it is cation. So according to our definition, that cation which attracts the negatively charged species. Negatively charged species is nothing but a pair of electrons. So now here, if it attracts the pair of electrons, it necessary to having the vacant orbitals. Okay. Vacant empty orbitals. Now here, all the orbitals filled by the electrons. There is no vacant orbitals. Okay. Now here it is the 2s 2p. After the 2s 2p, 2d orbitals are up. 2d is there. Okay. Now according to the our basic knowledge, 2d orbitals are not there. Okay. So due to the absence of 2d orbital, there is no vacant orbitals. That's why NH4 plus does not act as an electrophile. In similarly, H3O plus, so which is also not an electrophile, which is also not an electrophile. Why? Because here also similarly 2s2 2p4, so 2s2 2p4, 1 2 3, fourth electron. These two electrons are shared by the water. Okay, now again the pairing of these electrons, it forms the H3O plus. Now here there is no availability of 2d orbitals. Here also there is no availability of 2d orbitals. It is also act as an electrophile. Does not act as an electrophile. These two are the drawbacks of positively charged species or electrophiles. Okay. Now here, let us modify our statement. positively charged species are electrophiles, but some exceptions are there. Those are the like these type of NH4, like H3O plus ammonium cation and like hydronium ion. Hydronium ion. Now let's move on to the second point. Like second point. So simply it is nothing but a neutral species. Neutral species. Okay. Neutral species means, so if it does not having the positive charge, okay, so then how it attracts the pair of electrons, okay, how it attracts the pair of electrons, that is only possibility. So whenever it having the vacant orbitals, whenever it having the empty orbitals, then only it attract the pair of electrons. Simply like empty orbitals or vacant orbitals, or vacant orbitals are also called as electrophiles. Simply, so vacant orbitals, we know that the Lewis acid base concept. So Lewis acid base concept. So if a species which gains the pair of electrons, simply it is called as Lewis acid. So here, which gains the electron, which gains the electron, simply it is called as a Lewis acid. Which donates the pair of electron, then it is called as Lewis base. Okay, so according to the Lewis acid base concept, so the vacant orbitals are also called as Lewis acids. Simply, this is nothing but Lewis acids. Lewis acids. So Lewis acids, according to the Lewis acids, now here, like BF3, like BCl3, BBr3, Bi3. Okay, now here, AlCl3, SnCl4. So all these type of reagents are nothing but Lewis acids. Lewis acids. Simply, now let us modify that. Let us like announce the another statement. Lewis acids are electrophiles. Lewis acids are electrophiles. Now this is the second point. Now let's move on to the third point. Okay, now let's move on to the third point. So that is the like very interesting point. So not only vacant orbitals, electronically deficient species are also electrophiles. This is the third point. Electronically deficient species. Deficient species are called electrophiles. Okay, simply it is all electrophiles. So electronically deficient species is nothing but like B2H6, BH3, these type of compounds. B2H6 is nothing but boron, like boron, hydrogen, these are the sufficient bonds. Now here, these are the deficient bonds. This is the like diboron structure. Okay, so now here electronically deficient boron atom is present, like vacant orbital is present over the boron atom. Okay, now here this type of electronically deficient species are also called as electrophile. Simply like BH3, like B2H6, B4H10, B5H9, B5 like H11, B6H10. Okay, now B10H14. These type of all the type of higher borans are called as electronically deficient species. All the type of higher borans are an example of electrophiles. Simply it is nothing but it is also called as Bronsted acids. These are also act as Bronsted acids. Okay, the number of borans increases in higher borans, Bronsted acidity increases. Number of borans increases, Bronsted acidity increases. This is the like 2015 gate bit. This is the 2015 gate problem. Okay, now it is the third point. Now let's move on to the fourth point. Now here Lewis acids are there. Another category of Lewis acid, that is nothing but multiple bonds. So multiple bonds with different atoms. So now here multiple bonds with different atoms. CO2, SO3, P2O5, P4O10. Okay, like N2O5. Like N4O10, these type of bonds. Okay, all are the multiple bonds with different atoms. So these type of multiple bonds with different atoms, all these species act as an electrophiles. Okay, now here this is surrounded by the two more electronegativity atoms. Then middle of the atom, it act as a positively charged species. Simply it is act as electrophile. Now here multiple bonds with a different atom, it having the some of the exception. Now here CO, that is carbon monoxide, carbonyl group. Okay, now the carbonyl group, it having the like multiple bonds with a different atom, even though it having the multiple bonds with a different atom, it cannot act as an electrophile. Why? Because it act as a nucleophile in coordination chemistry. It act as a ligand. Okay, so it is the nucleophile, not the an electrophile. This is the an exception. Okay, now again, multiple bonds with the same atoms, like alkene, alkyne, those are act as a nucleophiles. Okay, these two drawback points are there over the multiple bonds in Lewis acid. This is the fourth point. Now let's move on to the fifth point, that is nothing but intermediates. Okay, now the types of reaction intermediates are there. Now here, carbocation, simply it is nothing but it is an electrophile itself. It is positively charged species, that's why it is an electrophile. Okay, now again, carbene, nitrene, as well as carbon free radical. So these four reactive intermediates are comes under electrophilic character. These four reactive intermediates which gains the electron from other species, that's why it act as like electrophiles. Now here, some of the statement regarding to the Lewis acid. All the Lewis acids are electrophiles, but all the electrophiles cannot Lewis acids. Why? Because, so this is the statement. So carbon free radical is there. Carbon free radical means it having the single electron. So an orbital having the single electron that cannot accept the pair of electron. So those type of cannot accepting pair of electron species are not Lewis acid. That's why all the Lewis acids are electrophiles, but all the electrophiles cannot Lewis acid. That is the true statement. Okay, this is the fifth type of reagent. Now let's move on to the sixth and seventh type. So here, electrophilic centers at reagents and substrates. Electrophilic centers at reagents and the substrates. Now let's move on to the sixth point. So electrophilic center at a reagent. Electrophilic center at reagent. Simply HCl, HF, HCl, HBr, HI. So all having the H plus as an electrophile. These are the reagents. Here all these type of hydrohalic acids, hydrohalogen acids, which are having the H plus as electrophile. Now similarly HOCl, HOBr, among these type of reagents here, Cl plus and Br plus act as an electrophiles. Now again NOCl, NOBr, here which also having the Cl plus and Br minus Br plus act as an electrophiles. So these are having these type of reagents which having the electrophilic centers like H plus and Cl plus, Br plus, Cl plus, Br plus, those type of reagents. Okay, now the seventh one. So here electrophilic center at a substrate. Now 8th point is also there. Now after the finishing of 7th point, we'll discuss the 8th point. Now substrate is nothing but different types of functional groups. Here it is aldehyde, like a ketone, like the acid, ester, amide, acid halide, anhydride. Okay, now here nitrile, like alkyl halide, alcohol, these type of substrates. Okay, all the type of substrate having the carbon which connected to the more electronegativity atom. So wherever the carbon atom which connected through the more electronegativity atom in case of multiple bonds, those species act as electrophilic centers. Not only multiple bonds, single bonds are also act as electrophilic center. This is the seventh point. Now the final point regarding to our electrophilic nature, that is the eighth point. So now we are all are aware about coordination chemistry. That is the eighth point. So in coordination chemistry, metals in coordination chemistry act as electrophiles. This is the eighth point. Okay, so some of the metals like Mg plus 2, cobalt plus 3, iron plus 2, which are available in chlorophyll, cyanocobalamin, hemoglobin, these type of reagents, copper plus one, these type of metal cations in coordination chemistry which act as electrophiles. These are the 8 points regarding to the electrophiles. Now let's move on to the nucleophilic reagents. Okay, now let's move on to the nucleophilic reagent. So now the second one is nucleophilicity reagent. Simply it is called as nucleophiles. Now here also it having the several types of reagents. Now the first one. Okay, so according to the definition of nucleophilicity, nucleus attracting species, or simply it is nothing but a nucleus loving species. Okay, so nucleus is nothing but a positively charged species. So now here positively charged loving species are called as nucleophiles. So when it attracts the positively charged species, whenever our substrate having the negative charge, then only it obstruct the positively charged spaces, or our substrate having the electronically reaching case, then only it obstruct the positively charged spaces. Okay, now let's move on to the those definitions. First one, negatively charged spaces. Negatively charged spaces. Okay, simply negatively charged spaces is nothing but H minus Cn minus Cl minus Br minus F minus iodine minus. These type of reagents are nothing but negatively charged spaces, which can act as nucleophiles, Now let's move on to the second point. So not only negatively charged spaces, some neutral spaces which also act as nucleophiles, neutral spaces. So in previous case, a neutral species means, that means whenever it having the vacant orbital, then only it is participating. Now here in case of nucleophiles, the neutral species is nothing but which having the lone pairs. Lone pairs, then only it act as nucleophiles. Now here, according to the Lewis acid base concept, so here vacant orbitals, here the pair of electrons. The species which accepting the pair of electrons, it is called as acids. The species which can donate the pair of electrons, which is called as base. Okay, Lewis bases, simply it is nothing but lone pairs is nothing but Lewis bases. Okay, Lewis basic species are called as nucleophiles, are called as nucleophiles. Now here Lewis bases means water which having the lone pairs, ammonia which having the lone pairs, alcohol which having the lone pairs, now ether which having the lone pairs. These type of lone pair containing species are called as nucleophiles. Now here this is a lone pair containing species or nothing but it is a neutral nucleophiles. Now let's move on to the third species. So according to the electrophiles, that is third is electronically deficient species. Now here electronically rich species, simply it is called as an electrophiles. Electronically rich species. Whenever the electronically rich position is there, whenever in presence of multiple bonds with the same atoms, CH2 double bond CH2 or CH triple bond CH or benzene, naphthalene, those type of rich compounds. Now here benzene is electronically more rich compound. See here it having the six pi electrons. Now here it is the two pi electrons, here it is the three pi, two pi bonds, that means four pi electrons. These are the electronically rich species. Unsaturated compounds are electronically rich species. Again, unsaturated compounds in conjugation, that means alternative double bonds. Okay, whenever this is participated in conjugation, then nucleophilicity decreases. So isolated double bonds more nucleophilic than the conjugated double bonds. More nucleophilic in nature than the conjugated double bonds. So this is the point. Okay, now here it is the third point. Now let's move on to the another points. That is the fourth point. So fourth one is organometallic reagent in metal atom, in the carbon atom, organometallic reagents. So this is the carbon metal, organometallic compounds. Okay, so in organometallic compounds, carbon atom act as a nucleophile. So this is the simple nucleophilicity, nucleophilic nature. Okay, so now let's move on to some of the organometallic compounds. The best organic compound, best organometallic is Grignard or MgX. Here it is the methyl magnesium chloride or ethyl magnesium bromide, these type of bonds. Here two types of bonds are there. So now here among these two, MgCl bond, it cannot break it. Now here RMg bond is break it. Now here it is the positive charge, it is the negative charge. According to the our definition, negatively charged spaces are nucleophiles. That's why in organometallic reagent, carbon atom act as nucleophiles. Not only Grignard reagent Gilman. So simply R2CuLi, simply it is nothing but methyl two times copper lithium. Here methyl minus is act as a nucleophile. Okay, not only Gilman's Frankland reagent, R2ZN, these type of reagents, dimethyl zinc, dimethyl cadmium, those type of reagents are also act as a nucleophile. Not only these type of reagent, organolithium compounds also R lithium, R minus and lithium plus. So we are already discussed in our like starting of the electro starting of this lecture. So alkali metals and alkali with metals which act as worst worst electrophiles. That means that is very weak electrophiles. That's why here it is the lithium plus is weak electrophile. Now here it is the more nucleophilic nature. Okay. Sometimes these type of organolithiums are only it having the like basic nature. Maybe if it is possible, I'll make the another video on the like basicity versus nucleophilicity. Okay. Now this is the fourth point. Now let's move on to the fifth point. So here the fifth point is nothing but like a Lewis bases. Already we have discussed, I don't want to waste our time. Now the fifth one, ligands in coordination chemistry or coordination compounds is nothing but nucleophiles. Okay, all the ligands in coordination chemistry, simply it is carbonyls, nitrosyls. Okay, now like PPH3, PR3, like any type of double bonds, alkenes, unsaturated compounds, not only like that, yes, CN minus halogens, like all type of halogen halide ions. Okay, these are all the like ligands. So ligands act as like a nucleophile. Not only these ligands, like ethylene diamine, these type of neutral ligands are there, EDTA. All the ligands act as nucleophiles. Now the like a sixth one. Now here, like reagents. Nucleophilic center in reagents as well as a nucleophilic center in substrate. Okay, now let's move on to the nucleophilic center in reagents. Okay, simply which are discussed in our previous class. So HCl, HBr, HI, these type of reagents which having the like a H plus and a Cl minus, Br minus, iodine minus. All the type of negatively charged species are nucleophilic centers. All the type of negatively charged species like HOBr, simply OH minus and Br plus. So Br plus is electrophile, OH minus is nucleophile. OH minus is nucleophile. This is the like another classification. Now let's move on to the like nucleophilicity final character, that is the seventh point. Nucleophilicity in substrates. Like a seventh point, nucleophilicity in substrates. Okay, now here in case of like aldehyde, like those type of all the type of functional groups, ketones. Okay, now here if it is the electrophilic center, then nucleophilic compound which attack over there, so then automatically bonded to electrons will shift towards the like above atom, then it seems to be O minus and positive. So positive center is called as electrophilic and negative center is called as nucleophilic. So these type of compounds are called as ambitype, like a duality. Sometimes it acts as electrophilic, sometimes it acts as nucleophilic. So now here one of the atom in those aldehyde species which act as electrophilic and another atom which act as nucleophilic in nature. So like in case of substrates like ROH alcohols, it act as an electrophile, it act as a nucleophile. This is the nucleophile. So this is an electrophile. This is an electrophile. Like not only alcohols, like alkyl halides. Okay, here it is the nucleophile, here it is the electrophile. These type of substrates, nucleophilicity in substrate. These are the 7 points in nucleophilicity. Okay, now we have discussed seven electrophilic points and seven nucleophilicity in points. Okay, now let's discuss the final things regarding these attacking reagents. Now finally we will discuss the 2 points regarding to these nucleophilicity. Okay, now here nucleophilicity. Okay, nucleophilicity is nothing but they are given in the 2 compounds, which one is more nucleophilic in nature. Okay, so it gives the information regarding to the more or less nucleophilicity. Okay, now here simply, so the first point, negatively charged nucleophiles versus neutral nucleophiles. Okay, so negatively charged nucleophiles and neutral nucleophiles, which is nothing but negative charge versus neutral, that is lone pairs. Okay, now among these two, negatively charged nucleophiles and neutral nucleophiles, negatively charged nucleophiles having the more nucleophilicity. Okay, negatively charged nucleophiles having the more nucleophilicity rather than the like neutral nucleophiles. That is the first point. Now the second point in nucleophilicity. Now I'll discuss the few points only. Now I don't want to go for the like detailed analysis. Okay, now here less electronegative, more nucleophilicity. More nucleophilicity. This is the major point. So many of the times they are given in the they are susceptible to the questions on these type of like nucleophilicity. Less electronegative. Like for example H2O, ammonia, like carbon CH4 is there. So among the four, which is more electronegative? So see, H2O is more electronegative. So this is the more electronegative, less nucleophile. More less electronegative, more nucleophile. Less electronegative, more nucleophile. Let us take the one of the example. So this is the like OH, like NH, NH2, which is treated with like acetic anhydride. Acetic anhydride, which donates the like acyl cation, which donates the acyl cation. Okay, now here two groups are there. One is a amine group and another one is a hydroxyl group. So among these two, which is more nucleophile? We don't know, but we are knowing about so oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. So oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. This is the electronegativity order. So electronegativity is different, inversely proportional to the nucleophilicity. Less electronegative, more nucleophilic. That means it is inversely proportionality. So that's why nucleophilicity order like this. Like oxygen is less than that of the NH2, that's why it forms this type of product, NHCOCH3. This is the product. This is nothing but a paracetamol. Okay, this is the 2020 JEE mains question. Don't forget these type of questions. A very simple concept, but they are susceptible in the JEE mains level questions, national level questions. Now, again, I'll discuss the not only nucleophilicity. Now, the nucleophilicity versus basicity. Nucleophilicity versus basicity. That is the final point to the our lecture. Nucleophilicity versus basicity. Okay, now here nucleophilicity versus basicity. So top to bottom in groups, particularly top to bottom, nucleophilicity increases in groups. Note down, in groups, top to bottom nucleophilicity increases. Top to bottom nucleophilicity increases, then automatically basicity decreases. Okay, now this is the quite opposite version. Okay, now here simply like we have the F minus, chlorine minus, Br minus, iodine minus. So top to bottom nucleophilicity increases, that's why it acts as a more nucleophilic in nature. This is the more nucleophilic in nature. Now here it is the more basic in nature. Not only these type of reagents like hydrates like NH3, like sulfur is more nucleophilic than oxygen. Like phosphorus is more nucleophilic than nitrogen. These type of exceptional character available based on the nucleophilicity versus basicity characteristic. That's all for this video. This is very helpful for the basic learners as well as JEE and NEET aspirants. Okay, I hope you guys it is very helpful for you. Thank you so much for watching.